Welcome. In this video, we will demonstrate how to record successful and failed deliveries using the fleXipod app. On the main menu screen, the alert next to the job list function shows that three jobs have been assigned to you. Let's open the job list and select the first job. You will then be taken to the job view screen. When you are ready to start the job, press open. Opening a job sends a timestamp message back to the central console. In this case, there are special instructions for this job. Let's open them and click on OK to acknowledge that they have been read, so that the alert is removed. The alerts next to the Delivery and Collect tabs show the number of items to be delivered or collected. In this case, there are 5 items to be delivered and none to be collected. Notice that the options to skip or fail the job become available after opening the job. Let's press the Delivery tab for a more detailed description of the items to be delivered. In this case, for lines 1 and 2, there is only one item of each product, whereas for lines 3, 4 and 5, there are multiple items of these products. Selecting the items for debrief can be done with a scanner or using the touchscreen on your device. In this case, we will use the touchscreen. To select an item, simply tap on it. Notice how the box at the top gets populated with the item code number. Pressing the clear button allows you to clear the box. Select an item and then press the go button to the right of the box to record a successful delivery. A green check mark will appear next to the item, which has been moved to the end of the list. For products with multiple items, you can select the product and enter inside the quantity box at the top of the screen the total number of items that you wish to pass as successfully delivered. Then click the go button. Or if you prefer, you can debrief them one by one by tapping on the product line and clicking the go button until the actual column gets populated with the same quantity as the expected column. Here's a tip. It is not possible to key in the item number directly onto the box. Make sure to either use a scanner or press on the item description until the box gets populated with the barcode or item number. Now, let's fail some items. Select an item and press the Fail Selected button at the bottom of your screen. You will then be presented with a list of valid reasons to fail the item. In this case, select Product Damaged and click Next. You will then be prompted to take a photograph of the item. Depending on the option selected, you could be prompted to enter a signature, add additional details, take a picture or fill in a form. All these options are configurable according to the specific business needs and requirements. A green check mark will appear next to the failed item indicating that it has been debriefed, followed by the reason provided, product damaged and quantity of failed items in red. If you wish to change a successful debrief, select the item and press the undo button at the bottom of your screen. You will then be taken to the product undo screen. Make sure that the number of items to undo is correct and click on OK. If you wish to change a failed debrief, first select the line that shows the failure reason and then press the undo button at the bottom of your screen. You will be presented once more with the product undo screen, where you can enter the quantity of items to be undone, but in this case we are going to cancel this action because for this example we wish to keep this debrief as a failure. At the bottom of your screen there are two further options available to you, pass remainder and failed remainder, to record a successful or failed delivery for all remaining items on the screen respectively. Let's select pass remainder. You will then be presented with a pass remainder dialog. Select yes to confirm that you want to record a successful delivery for all remaining items. Once the delivery for all items has been recorded, you will be taken directly to the job complete screen. At the top of this screen, there is the customer's name and the current date and time, followed by the signed by drop-down to select whether the signature will be provided by the customer or on behalf of the customer. On the box below, the name of the person signing can be entered using your keyboard. Then, have the customer sign inside the white box and press OK. You will then be presented with a signature confirmation dialog. This double confirm on the signature screen is to prevent high screen sensitivity, enabling the OK button without capturing a clear signature. After verifying the signature, press OK to finally complete the job. After completing the job, you will be taken back to the job list screen, where you can continue debriefing the rest of your jobs. Notice that the manifest status has changed to in progress, and the alert next to the quick jobs list icon shows the remaining number of pending jobs. When a job is completed, the device will send a timestamp message back to the central console. We hope that you find this tutorial useful. Goodbye.